H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Okay, cool. So then let me go ahead. Okay. So yesterday we had discussed about input formats and everything, right? So we will have a look for just 5 to 10 minutes about the output formats as well, and then we will directly jump into our partitioner. So today we would be discussing about the partitioner theoretical topics, and I will explain you with an example. And after that, along with the theory, we will have a hands-on of partitioner as well today. So guys, remember that we are going a bit slowly in our course, so I am preferring to take at least 1.5 hour daily for our next maybe 2 or 10 sessions. The only reason I am doing that is I just don't wanted to skip any of the topic. So whatever the topics I am explaining were really really important, and you have to learn those topics once the course is finished. So that is the reason I don't want to skip any of the things. So if it is fine with everyone to have a 1.5 hour class from tomorrow, or maybe from today onwards, we will go ahead. So is that okay with everyone? Or if anyone has any issues, I am fine to go ahead with 1 hour as well. So it's up to you that on what way you want to go. So okay, Arjun is fine. Nisha is fine. So what about Rahul and Akshay? What I am saying, Rahul, is like I just wanted to take classes for the next 10 classes for 1.5 hour session. So till now we had taken 1 hour sessions, right? So as we are a bit lagging on the topics, I just wanted to take it for 1.5 year. The reason I wanted to take for 1.5 hour is I just don't wanted to skip any of the topics. Maybe going ahead even in MapReduce or Pig, Hive, HBase, Flume or Scope. So even with any of the topics, I just don't wanted to skip. That's it. Okay, fine. Fine guys, thank you for supporting me. So okay, so let's go ahead with our topic without any delay. We will have probably 12 classes, I think, Rahul, but I will check. Anyways, I will check. I mean, as per the topics I'm going, but probably we'll have around 12 classes. Output formats. So we had seen many forms of our input format, right? It can be text input format, or inline sequence input format, or binary types, that is sequence input formats, and key value text input formats. So we had seen different forms of input formats. As output formats are not much complex when compared to our input formats, so we have only few types of output formats when we compare to our input formats. So the major output formats generally we would be discussing about are text output format and map file output format, and the last one is nothing but the sequence file output format, which is as equivalent to our sequence file input formats. So whenever I am using sequence file input format, I would go and prefer for a sequence file output format. So the same case is with the remaining two as well. So if at all I am using text input format, which is my default one, the default output format will come into picture, and that is text output format. So with the text output format, I will write records as lines of text only. So everything will be in the form of key value pair, and it will turn all the key values as strings. Internally, it will call a Java program to convert all the key value pairs into strings, and that Java program is toString program. Internally calls a Java program called as toString, such that it will convert all key comma values as strings. So each key value pair again is separated by a tab character. So by default it will take tab character as a separator. Okay, so that is what about our text output format. So coming to file output format, using reducers, using this, even the reducers can emit keys in sort order. So till now, whatever the mapper is sending to us, that is the intermediate key value pairs, we have a separate phase called, right, shuffle and sort phase, such that the reducer will be able to read them in sorted order. So maybe the keys might be in different orders. For example, it may start with I comma 2, how comma 4, and maybe or comma 3. So if it reads in this format, the mapper reads in this format, it might emit the values as, it will emit in the format as or comma, maybe some combination, it may go to some 6 or something. So it's all depends in between the aggregation logic and then hi comma some 8 or 7 and how comma 2. Okay, it's already having delete. Okay, nine. Let's take like this. So after our shuffle and sort phase, we would be getting it in a sorted order. So if you observe here, my keys are in sorted order. So A is first coming, and then H is coming, and then the next consequence, which is O. After I would be getting O, and that's the reason I'm getting how after I. So this will be my outputs from my shuffle and sort phase. So once the reducer reads everything, my file output format will helps me to emit keys in sorted order. So this is the one which is used to generate automatically everything in a sorted order. So okay, and the next one is sequence file output format. So as I told you, we would be generating all keys and values in binary format here. So in sequence file input format and output format as well, the processing will be happening only in the binary ways. So for any of the text files or any of the unstructured data as well, maybe not unstructured data, for semi-structured data, I would be using the above formats only, maybe the map file output formats, text output formats, etc., etc. But when it comes to images and all, I would be using the sequence formats. So the inputs and outputs would be sequence input format and output formats. So I will talk much more about when I come to image processing topic. Okay, so these are the few important or major output formats that we can discuss about. So let's don't waste our time and we will jump into our partitioner. So the whole MapReduce program can be differentiated or divided into two parts called as partitioners, and the second one is combiners. So in partitioners, what I'm doing is partitioners determine which reducer is responsible for a particular key. And combiners can be viewed as mini reducers in the map phase. So don't bother about the combiners. We can discuss about it once we finish the partitioners topic, but right now just concentrate on partitioner topic. So partitioner, it is nothing but the function of partitioner is it will decide that which key should go to which reducer. So let's take our old example, that is the cart examples. So as I told you, I would be using the same example for whole of the map reduce topics, and slowly I will add complexities to it. So we all remember about this one, right? So how many cards are there in our pack, and my expected is I just wanted to know how many cards are there as per the keys. So if I consider keys in this cards example, there will be four keys, right? One is club, diamond, heart, and the last one is spade. So for each of the keys I want to know the count. So my expected output is club comma 13, diamond comma 13, heart comma 13, and spade comma 13. So just let me explain you again on a very high level, just to make you remind of what this example is about. So I am having an input file as cards.txt. Maybe it can be of any size, don't worry about the sizes right now. And after it is sent to our cluster, it was divided into four input splits. So I am not talking about blocks right now, I'm talking about splits. So if at all, imagine that if we got four splits out of our text file, there should be four reducers to process these four input splits, right? Sorry, four mappers to process these four input splits. So that's the reason I had drawn four mappers. And after that, there will be a phase called as partitioner phase, right? So for each of the mapper, a partitioner phase came into picture. It's not like every time whenever I write a MapReduce program, partitioner should come into picture. Partitioner will only come into picture whenever there are more than one reducer. So if at all I am having only one reducer, there is no concept of partitioner. Only if the case that I am having reducers more than one, then only the partitioner will come into picture. It might be the default partitioner which I am not going to write, and just the framework will take care about it, or maybe I can write a custom partitioner as well, such that I want to divide those keys as per my wish. So that is what the partitioner is about. So whenever a reducer comes into picture, the shuffle and sort phase will be divided into two parts. So it will be separate for each of the reducer. Okay. So the shuffle and sort phase will come or will happens twice for each of the reducer. So for reducer 1, maybe I can expect like all my hearts and clubs should go to actually the reducers, the naming function will start with 0 and 1, okay? So it always starts with 0. So all my hearts and clubs should go to reducer 0, and all my diamonds and spades should go to reducer 1. So this is what I require. So reducer 1 should have the outputs as club comma 13. Where is this? Our text is not coming. Okay, club comma 13 and heart comma 13. And this should have spade comma 13 and diamond comma 13. So this is what my expectation is. So what my partitioner does is, for example, if the first club key goes into reducer 1, it will make that all the remaining club keys also goes to reducer 1 only, or maybe reducer 0. So whatever the reducer it has decided for the first time, and in the later phases also, it will go to the same reducer. So the logic behind it is, partitioner generates a hash code for every key. Both. Okay. And says to divide the keys as key hash code modulo 2. So 2 is my number of reducers. Okay, so if at all I'm having 3 reducers, I will have the logic as key hash code modulo 3. So is everyone aware about this modulo function? Or just let me know if anyone is not able to understand about the functionality of modulo. So I'll try to explain about that as well. Okay, fine. So modulo is nothing but it's just a reminder. Okay, so tell me one thing, any number modulo 2, what will be the output? So I told you that modulo is nothing but remainder, right? So if at all I divide any number by 2, what would be my remainders? What are the possible cases for me to get remainders? Can you think? Right, perfect. So every time I can get a remainder of 0 or 1 only. So for example, if I take 31 as any number case, then 31 modulo 2 is just 1, right? So if I take 30 modulo 2, I will get the remainder as 0. So any number, if you take it and divide by 2, you may get the output as 0 or 1, right? So this is what it takes. So hash code, it's nothing but there is something Java calculates for you for every object that is given to it, and it will convert a number taking the ASCII number as input. So for example, it takes the club as input. So internally it will have a hash code number. So for this object it was assigned a hash code number. So might be, it can be of any something like this number. Okay, so that is the ASCII value. So it will convert this ASCII number into a proper number. So that proper number might be something 35,000 or something. So every time when our Java code comes across this club key, it will generate the hash code as 35,000 only, and it is stable. So it will not change any time until this process, or not only even this process, even though I call the next time also, it will generate the hash code as 35,000 only, whenever it processes the same program. So for the same key, the hash code will remain same. So for club, I got 35,000. So what happens is 35,000 modulo 2. So what it will generate? It will generate 0. So that means it says that, okay, whenever you get a key as club, go to reducer 0 only. So by this, defaultly, it will go to reducer 0. And suppose if you take for hat, imagine that you got your output as some 46,000. Okay, then what my partitioner does is, okay, key hash code modulo 2 means 46,000 modulo 2, which is again 0. So no doubt, go to reducer 0. So that's what happens. So again, if you take diamond and spades, you may getting some different modulo number, such that it will make like, okay, go to this reducer or go to that reducer. So is it okay with everyone? So as of now, the default partitioner is implemented by framework, but it can always be customized. It's in developer hand. Okay, so maybe imagine like the logic should divide the workload equally between n reducers. So if you go to the default partitioner, the program or the framework will take like how much workload it should give for reducers. But whenever I go to my custom reducer, it's up to me like how much workload I want to give my reducers, right? So if at all I plan like the first three keys should go to reducer 1 and only the last key should go to reducer 2, then definitely the workload on reducer 1 will be more, right? So it's again into the developer's hand, like how you want to divide your keys into reducers. If you want to maintain workload balance, okay, it's up to you that you divide equally to both of your reducers. No, my requirement is like, why would something like that be useful in the real world? Can you give example? Okay. Let me take an example. Real world example, you want to talk about it, okay. So suppose maybe you have a file and you are getting all the data of SQL stuff into HDFS, okay. So and based on that SQL stuff, you want to process all the data on your SQL database in one program, and maybe again you are connecting to Oracle database, okay. So and you are pulling all your Oracle database into your HDFS and you want to process it separately. So what you want to do is, you want to have all the Oracle stuff into one output file and maybe the SQL stuff into two output files, and you want to process it separately. Maybe that your SQL processing may contain a different information, maybe different customers. Suppose you have two customers in your SQL processing, in the sense SQL database, and you want to take your customer analysis separately for your SQL database. Maybe that might be very huge, or the customers you are looking into your SQL database has some issues. So you want to analyze them. Maybe they are new customers. So then what you will do is, you will take customer 1 into one output file such that you can analyze it quickly, or you can generate reports on your customer 1 only. And for customer 2, again, as he is a new customer, you want to generate a report separately for him. But when it comes to Oracle database, they are not new customers, and you don't want to analyze what they are doing. You just wanted to send a report for them, like, okay, this customer is from 1950 or 1960 and he had bought these many products till now. That is only the requirement. But when it's coming to your DB database, that is SQL database, you want to get all the information like customer start date and how many products he has bought for each of the month, how much he had paid and how much he has pending amounts, and if at all he got some credits, how much credits he got till now. So you want to calculate much more on customers who are from PLSQL. So then what you will do is, you will calculate the customer 1 file into one reducer through one reducer, such that you will get much more information. And again, you want to generate one more report on customer 2, and that might be the reason you are going to for second reducer as well. But when it comes to Oracle database, you don't want to generate any reports, just you want to send them the analysis, like, okay, this customer is from this time and he bought these many products, that's it. So at the time, I don't want to go to different reducers, right? Is that fine, Rahul? So these multiple reducers represent different reduce classes. No. I will declare all these multiple reducers only in a one reduce multiple class. So I will show you, or I will explain you once the theoretical concept is finished. So once I go to hands-on, I will show you how you will declare multiple reducers. Okay? So the beauty of Hadoop comes only at this time. You don't need to write multiple programs to process all these things. Even though you take 100 reducers, I will write only one program. So only one program can generate multiple number of output files. Is that fine? Okay, thank you. So, okay, suppose take that you have 3 reducers. Okay, so then how my logic works is, suppose our Java has produced the hash codes as club hash code as 35,000 diamond hash code as some 6621. And then heart hash code as some 000. I'm just imagining all these numbers, okay? So, but it's up to our Java king that how he derives some 66447. Okay, and I want to know, like, which key goes to which reducer. So it will be 35,000 modulo 3. So I'm poor in calculations. You calculate it and tell me to which reducer it will go. Well, 6221 modulo 3, 11000 modulo 3, 447 modulo 3. So tell me, what are the outputs? What are the reminders? 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 7, 4, 4, 35,000 modulo. Is this modulo? I'm not sure. Oh, sorry, something gone away. 35,000 is this percentage. No guys, I'm not sure how to do it in calculator, but you can have it on it on by yourself. Okay, so for 2 I can easily say that, and maybe after this there should be some reminder going into your division rule, as per your division rule. So for that it will go to that reducer. You can have a hands-on divider. Okay, so you can work on it. Okay, 2. Arjun is saying 2. Thank you, man. So then it will go to reducer 1. So because every reducer will start with reducer 0, 1, 2. If at all I say that I have 3 reducers, it will start with 0, 1 and 2. Okay, so as per those reminders, they will go to that particular reducer. So that's what the reducer logic is about. So let me write this again so that it will be helpful for you for reference in your future. All keys are bifurcated by partitioner, same key will always go to same reducer, number of reducers is has to be by you, and the default is 1 when the whole logic works on hash code. Okay, mapper is like everyone minding their own business and shuffle and sort is data being sorted user output. Okay, so guy it uses, so so when it comes to who handles which things, mapper comma reducer needs to be taken care by developer, and partitioner it can be taken care by framework as well as developer. Shuffle and sort it will be taken by framework, and if at all if any functions I will include here again. Okay, so is everybody clear about this? So can we go ahead? And of course, framework we will see how we can inference this. Why? Okay. So if everybody is okay with the theoretical topic, I will go ahead. Or let me know if you have any questions. So is it fine, guys? Can I go ahead? Come on, man, I'm not getting any single nod even. Okay. Cool. So the reason why I am asking you separately is it is very important. It's not like as simple as I explained you. There is much more that we can play with Partitioner. But the things whatever I am explaining you are like basics to understand what the concept is about. So let's see some hands-on on it. Guys, you are able to see my screen, right? I am entering into VM, so that's the reason I am asking you. Okay, cool. Okay, so fine, all good. We have everything ready. Let me see the files of how I am having before I go ahead into program. Okay, so all good. Okay, let's take the same example. This is the same example, if you remember, I had taken for word count, right? So this is what the text contains. So what we did in word count is we had separated each of the word in our input file and we had generated as word comma value, word comma value, word comma value. How many times it has repeated, we had given in that way. So let me see if I had my output here. So this is what we had generated in our word count program, right? So if you remember, as per the default formats, so our default format what we had taken is text input format and text input output format, and that is the reason that my key and values are separated by a tab. So if at all I had taken some other input format, I would have seen my output in maybe some let comma 1 or let colon 1 or something like that. So it's my wish that how I can give. So I had taken the default one and that's the reason I got as tab separated. Okay, so everything is fine, I hope. We can go ahead. So this is my program, and as you remember, I am getting all my libraries required. Okay, so these are the at least required minimum libraries that I have to import into my classes, or else you would be getting errors. Okay, limit. So let us start from mapper. Okay, so guys, I'm not going to explain you this mapper function because it is as similar as word count function. So just go through it and let me know if you find any difference or if it is same with my mapper function. Just for a second, just go through the program and let me know if you find any difference when compared to my word count program. And also, let me tell you one more thing. Yesterday we had discussed about new APIs and old APIs, right? So what is this? Is this a new API or old API? By seeing this, you should be knowing. Word mapper, extends MapReduce, base, implements mapper. Is it the old one or new one? Rahul is telling is new. So how many of you agree with this? So okay, Arjun is also telling it as new API.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.